Hello everybody, this here is Moot, and today I'm going to be reviewing the wonderful electro-harmonix stereo polyphase. This is a lot different than the old polyphase. This is, first of all, true stereo, and they totally redesigned it. I mean, they really could have called it something else, but whatever. It's the stereo polyphase. So, the way I'm running this is directly into the computer through a tube preamp so you can hear the stereo effect. So here's my dry sound. I'm running through amplitude 3. I'm running through two identical amp simulators. Got a little tremolo bleed there. So here is the polyphase. Just with this typical setting. You can really see how wide this thing sweeps. I mean, it's amazing. The stereo image is really beautiful on a RHODES. Now what's great is that you can specify the start and stop frequencies of the sweep. So if I start moving the start knob up, now it's only affecting the high frequencies, it's leaving everything else alone, which is really great. And also, conversely, I could do it the opposite way. I could take the stop frequency to a lower frequency. You can just think of these almost like a high pass and a low pass filter, respectively. So there's like nothing going on. If you'll notice, the sound is panned. I wonder if what happens. It pans it the other way. Now, if you reverse these, it will reverse the phase. Same thing, just phase inverted. But what's great is being able to really dial in what frequencies you want to be affected by the phaser, which is perfect for the RHODES, which has a pretty unique frequency range. It's also great for doing special effects. You can almost get a Leslie sound. But yeah, it's just as wide or narrow a phase as you want. It's fantastic. Also, we start turning the feedback, you can really hear more effect. Here's halfway. O'clock. all the way up. Try it again. And man, you could make so many spacey things with this. Beautiful. So we haven't even talked about the other modes that this thing has. It doesn't, well, first of all, you can change the LFO from a triangle wave to a square wave if you want. It's not, I don't find it that useful, but you can do lots of cool, like, synthetic kind of effects, like a... almost turns it into a filter type of effect, and that's what I'm going to talk about next. So now in envelope mode, this thing is an envelope phaser. So you've heard of an envelope filter, like a Mutron 3 or a Qtron, or you know, anything like that. This is very similar, but with phasing rather than filtering, but you end up with a lot of the same type of thing. This is where gain comes in. You need to have enough gain to get the thing actually doing something. Now, in this mode, the toggle switch controls how fast the envelope responds to input. Right now, I've got it in slow. Fast is a little more funky. See, now it's starting to sound like an envelope filter. Like this is almost starting to be like a cutoff frequency control on a filter. If you get it just at that threshold, it's cool. You can get these like fluttery Yeah. So there's that. There's the envelope. Okay, so now I've hooked up an expression pedal, and I put it in expression mode, and now we can use it almost like a foot wah. The rate doesn't do anything in this mode. It's really weird using the foot to do this. I think it's more fun with the feedback all the way up, though. I might just have to make a track with that. Anyway, there it is, the stereo polyphase.